Happy noon, children. Once again, welcome to the online science class. Okay. In the previous video, we have started a lesson, new lesson, fiber to fabric. Okay. In this lesson, we have detailed look at what is fiber. What is fiber, ma? Okay, what is fiber? The fiber is a natural thing. For example, we have to take cotton fiber. A thin string is called as fiber, isn't it? There are two types of fiber. We have learned that are natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Natural fibers are obtained from the natural things like plants and animals. And synthetic fibers, the natural fibers are added with some chemicals and they have converted into the synthetic fibers. Okay, natural fibers are of two types. One is plant fibers. Second one is animal fibers. Plant fibers, what are the examples? Cotton, jute. And animal fibers, wool, silk, etc. Okay. These are obtained from the animals that are sheep and cocoon something. Okay, we have seen. In the next topic, we are going to see about the plant fibers. There are the two most famous fibers are cotton and jute. Okay, this is the cotton plant, children. This cotton fiber is obtained from cotton plant. Cotton plants are usually grown at places having black soil and a warm climate. These plants are mostly grown in the places that are having black color soil. The soil will be in black color and a warm climate. Next one, the cotton fiber is obtained from the fruit of the cotton plant. That are called cotton bolls. The fruit of the cotton plant are called cotton bolls. It will be, look at the size of a lemon. After the maturing of the that fruit, the bolls will burst. And the seeds covered with cotton fibers can be seen. It will be look like this. This is a bursted bowl, cotton bowl. In this we have cotton fiber like that. Within this fiber the cotton seeds are there. If you see in a cotton field which is ready for picking, which is ready for harvesting, it will looks like a field covered with snow. White color snow. It looks like that. From these balls, the cotton is usually picked by hands. We have to pick the cotton balls by hand. Then after picking, the fibers and the seeds are separated from the seeds by combing. Combing our hair, isn't it? In book page number 20, you have a picture 3.7, that is ginning of cotton. That is a method used to separate the cotton fiber from the seeds, cotton seeds. This process is known as ginning of cotton. Ginning was usually done by hand. We have to separate the cotton seeds and the fibers with our hands. Nowadays many machines are many machines are there to do the this ginning. This is the separated fiber from the seed. This is the separated fiber from the cotton seeds. Okay, next one, this is the cotton yarn. Okay, after separating, after the process of ginning, the cotton will be changed into yarn. Okay, and at the last I will see, I will show you a video. In that video you will see how to make a cotton fiber into yarn. Okay, okay, this is called a spinning. Okay, after spinning, after done the spin process spinning, it will make it will makes into yarn. Okay, okay, next one, the next plant fiber is famous plant fiber is jute plant. Okay, this is the plant, the green color is jute plant, and this is the next one is the jute fiber. Okay, actually the jute fiber is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. Okay, it is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. Okay, we can see the jute plants mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar and Assam in India. Okay, next one, the stems of the harvested plants are immersed in water for a few days. We have to, after harvesting the jute plant, okay, the stems of the plants should be, jute plants should be immersed in water for few days. Next, the stems rot and the fibers are separated by hand. Okay, after that we have to separate the stem rods and fibers. Okay, within the stem rod, it inside the jute fiber will be there. We have to separate it by our hands. Okay, next, okay, this is up to cotton and jute. Next one, to make fabric, all these fibers are first converted into yarns. Okay, after that I will show you. This is the jute string, jute rope made up of jute fiber. Next one, spinning cotton yarn. Spinning cotton yarn, the process of making yarn from fibers is called spinning. Okay, the process of making yarn from fibers is called, that process is called spinning. Okay, in this process the fibers are fibers from a mass of cotton wool are drawn out and it twisted. Okay, we have to continuously twist the cotton fiber. Okay, this brings the fibers together. Continuously we are twisting the fiber, it will turn into the yarn like a thread. Okay, to perform this spinning action, the simple device we are using called is a hand spindle. Okay, hand spindle. Now you are looking in the picture, you are looking at the hand spindle, and also it is called a thakli. Okay, its another name is thakli. Okay, next one, another hand operated machine is famous for the spinning is charkha. Okay, what is that? Charkha. Okay, you may familiar with this device in our Mahatma Gandhi's. Okay, Mahatma Gandhi's pictures, always he will doing like this, sit in the land, sit in the floor, and he will spinning, do the spinning with the, with this charkha machine. Okay, okay, this was used in the at the time of independence movement. Okay, independence movement by Gandhiji, Mahatma Gandhi. He encouraged people to wear clothes made from homespun yarn. Okay, that is nowadays it is called as khadi. Okay, that is called as khadi. Okay, to popularize this and promote khadi, the government of India constituted a body called Khadi and Village Industries Commission in 1956. Nowadays you have see many shops like Khadi Craft, isn't it? Okay, this is a shop that is the government constituted that to promote the Khadi and the village industries. Okay, in this shop the cloth, the fabrics should be came from the village side. Okay, village side, and usually it is made of homespun yarn. Okay. Okay, the spinning of yarn is on a large scale is done with the help of spinning machines. Okay, these are very simple machines nowadays. The biggest, largest machines are used for spinning. Okay, spinning yarns. Next one, after spinning the yarn, next they have dyed. Okay, dyed means it they will be colored. Okay. Nowadays many colored fabrics are we are used, isn't it? Okay, for that purpose, after spinning the yarn, the yarns are colored. Okay, colored by adding dyes in that. Okay children, up to this it's enough, and also I will show a video to you. Watch it carefully. Okay, now you can watch the video.
Spinning cotton yarn. We have variety of things made of cotton. For example, clothes, bed sheets, towels, fishing nets, tents, etc. In order to make these things, we cannot use cotton fibers directly. It is because they does not have required length and strength. We need to convert cotton fibers into yarn. The process of making yarn from cotton fibers is called spinning. You can do it at your home as well. Here is a method. Take some cotton and remove seeds from it. With one hand, pull some fibers from the cotton and twist them continuously. By doing so, fibers come close to each other. They hold each other tightly and we get a long string. The long and strong string obtained by twisting fibers together is cotton yarn. Fabric is made from yarn. We get variety of fabric based on amount of twist in the yarn. For example, low twist makes soft, bulky and velvety fabric, while very high twist makes silky, shiny fabric. In general, average twist is used to make most common fabrics. A simple device used for making yarn is hand spindle. It is also called dakli. A famous hand-operated device is charkha. Mahatma Gandhi popularized it during independence movement. Nowadays, spinning machines are used to produce yarn on large quantity. These machines produce yarn with good quality. Here we complete this topic. Visit learnfatafat.com for more such interesting videos.
Okay children, have you watched that video? Okay, read the lesson up to this topic. Okay, go through the lesson carefully. We will meet in the next video or direct class. Okay children, thank you.